his opponent from St. Louis, Missouri, and making his home now in Phoenix, Arizona, weighing 234, the recognized National Alliance champion, Thesz.
Thesz, the National Wrestling Alliance champion against Antonino Rocca in one of the great matches, one of the greatest matches that Buffalo has seen. Here are a couple of fellas that are top-notchers, and, well, I'll tell you, this match would fill Madison Square Garden where it's being held there tonight, but it's being held in Buffalo. And a couple of great athletes, a couple of fellas who are in great physical condition, and the National Wrestling Alliance belt, which is now being worn by Thesz, and you can see right now as his second takes it off, is at stake tonight. Lou won that by beating Buddy Rogers in Toronto a while ago. And Lou is very careful about that. You see that? He's talking over with a second. He doesn't want to lose that belt. Here he comes, one of the finest conditioned athletes in the wrestling game against the fellow who matches him in skill and strength, Argentina Rock. See some scientific wrestling with these two fellows. Sometimes, and this is an oddity of wrestling, sometimes when you see these fellows who really can wrestle go at it, the crowd doesn't like it as much as they do the fellows who whack away at each other. Another takedown by Thesz. Possibility of a choke here. Teddy Thomas is in there to look at it. But that leg is on the throat. Now, Rocca broke it up himself by turning left like that. Thesz hangs on with that head scissor until Rocca kicks it through once again. Gets the first hole. That's his first head to move.
Now here's the champion moving out between the ropes.
These fellas, of course, will jockey with the referee trying to get him to give them another advantage. Lou once again ducks out between those top two ropes.
Toward Rocca. They'd like to see the champion dethroned tonight.
Thesz once again goes for the ropes, breaks it up. Thank you.
is now on top. And he has the left arm of Rocca tied up in a figure four leg lock. This, of course, puts that arm to sleep if you hold it long enough. Rocca now comes out of it. He has Thesz for a moment. Thesz went for the opening. Get out of the ring. Now it's Thesz taking the initiative. He's got that fist closed, too, as he pounds away at Rocca's forehead and face. Using the elbow, too. Look out here. Rocca down. He got him. Thesz got him. He got right to Tina Rocca, and that's the first time we've seen him pin. Inspiration rolling off the back of Argentina Rocca and also off his forehead and his neck as he maintains pressure on Lou Thesz. And Lou, bulldog that he is, will not give in. Teddy Thomas keeps going in to ask if he'll give in, and he won't. Now Lou has what Teddy Thomas considers a chokehold on Rocca. Here's a hit. And Thesz got out of it. He broke up. Got a quick headlock. The head scissors on Rocca, but he couldn't hold it. Rocca got. Rocca now trying to break it, and Thesz, you'll notice his left leg is catching onto the rope. Rocca doesn't have a chance for this flying Mary's trying to do. He'll strain and he'll struggle, but he won't do it as long. Oh, he may have a chance. He didn't. He went the other way. There's the hip roll and back in the headlock. Got two. Oh, that's a new count. That's it. He got it. Over Lou Thesz. In a vicious battle between two beautifully conditioned athletes. You can tell how savage the going was in that one. Lou Thesz still lying in the middle of the ring. After being counted out by referee Teddy Thomas, and Thesz has no complaint about the call. Here's Manny White.
The time, 10 minutes and 10 seconds, the winner, Argentina Rocca.